Welcome back. Game number two here for this best of three in the ESL One Frankfurt qualifiers. I'm Gareth in the JD Studios, and we're through Team Alternate Attacks up against Fantastic Five. And, well, hang on a second. Sven, is this a rerun? Sven. No, it's not Sven. That's a new hero. Mopax. Things started off pretty similarly to game number one now. Invoker Earth Spirit and Beastmaster Wisp.
Yeah, not exactly the newest hero around the block in 6.86, but it's new to our series, so it's kind of nice here. Yeah, a little bit of a block, as you know. And there is still that Tiny, though, so they're really scared of that CK Gyro. Can't blame them. I'm okay with that. I believe our bans also look the same with that OD and Nature's Prophet. I think they like that because they love the Invoker so much from ATN and from Alternate that they're just like, yep, let's just make sure we get our Invoker. Don't want to deal with OD. Want him to have a really good time in the mid lane.
And then having the Earth Spirits really push that tempo a little bit harder as well in the laning stage, always going to help out. But Team Alternate, they pick up the Sven, obviously a good pairing with the Wisp, allowing F5 to get their hands on the Tiny again if they really want Witch to, Doctor. But it's going to be the Witch Doctor that they aim towards. And that kind of works two ways. It's a good kind of solid laning support, going to deal well with really whatever Alternate throws at them, pretty good against Earth Spirit rolling away. The Cask is nice against Forge Spirits as well. But if Alternate wanted to go for a Chen here, not likely. You know, you kind of leave yourself with three solo heroes and a deficit in the lanes. But if Alternate wanted to go for a Chen, Witch Doctor, also pretty good against them.
Oh, man. I tell you, he has a sick win rate on Dire Side. I haven't looked at it. It's over 60%. It's over 65%, I want to say. Chen Dire. Like, it's just so good. Which makes sense, because it lets you take that bottom Radiant Tower so quickly. And then the whole jungle just becomes yours. And with a Sven, like, I'm digging that, personally. If they wanted to go for that. So the Witch Doctor is definitely a solid option here for them. And it kind of works like the Bane, right? Roaming around, setting up stuff. But not quite the same level of commitment, right? You don't have to worry about the full channel for the control. Channel for the damage, yes. But it's more important, I think, that they've already seen that they want to be stunning up that spend as much as possible.
Lina. Well, Lina. That's an interesting pick. Sven Lina is an age-old combo for the safe lane, stun into death for anyone that dares oppose them. And with no Oracle apparent being banned out by F5 in the second stage, probably going to go and deal with that Beastmaster up on top lane as much as they possibly can. Mm. I guess the Witch Doctor also a relatively good block pick against Alternate if they wanted the Witch Doctor. Pairs up nicely with Sven up against the Beastmaster as well on top of it. Remaining. But F5, they've still got their mid and their safe lane left to pick here. We saw BZZ's Quap do well in the kind of early to mid game, even towards the 45-50 minute mark, still pumping out a lot of control, but damage was lacking. And you even saw his decision making going back for the Maelstrom on the Quap, making sure he could do as much as he could in those team fights, but it just wasn't enough. They need something a lot more strength behind it. I do wonder what
to touch on the Lina as well. I think the fact that, like, the way that last game went, where Fantastic Five did a fantastic job of just splitting up the whole map, right? Like, there was that massive mid-game period where Alternate were having a really hard time actually catching them out and getting something done. But the benefit of the Lina is that at least they will be able to do this whole, like, split push with a support thing as well, which was something they were, like, missing pretty heavily in the last game. And now we get the Bristle, so it won't be the Tiny. We threw this out as a possibility during the first game, but they're going to opt for it now. I wonder if it's... I guess drawn out fights are really good against Sven, right? Like the fact that he needs that perfect blink stun, God strength, kill you out. So Bristleback able to help kite him around. This looks pretty solid and much tankier up against the Invoker.
Reserve time. Yeah, most certainly. This could indicate a shift for Alternate. Switch the Invoker from Exort to Wex, possibly. EMP really good with the Tornado against all of these heroes from F5. Two tanky melee cores, the Bristle and the Beastmaster, two relatively squishy heroes between the Wisp and the Witch Doctor. Could still get destroyed by a Wex Invoker if they wanted to go that way. 10 seconds remaining. We'll remove the BZZ Puck, though.
That's a good ban as well. No surprise there. Jeez, that would have been disastrous giving that up. Sven, Lina, Earth Spirit Invoker, the dream.
I think Slaughter could work reasonably well here for Team Alternate as an offlane hero. Give you that minus armor against Bristle, gives you some control. Legion. There aren't too many stuns on lanes, so you can just sprint yourself back to safety. Having another Blink Initiator, but it's going to be the Batrider as your Blink Initiation for the offlane here for Radiant Team Alternate. Team pick. I guess it's going to be a little bit easier farming into the Blink for him, but an Alchemist for Fantastic Five. B BZZ is going to be playing up that one against the Invoker. That's an interesting one, especially in the early stages when you've got Earth Spirit, Lina, who can roam in onto that lane. BZZ, I think they have to sit Yol with him for the initial stage. Or do they? Oh, is that going to be safe lane Alc and they run Bristle Wisp mid?
No, can't. I hope not. I hate safe lane Alc. You need the runes. But the other thing is, they already do have an Earth Spirit and a Lina, which is the other big reason why this is a little bit scary, because you really need those bounty runes to accelerate the Alchemist. That's like one of the biggest reasons to pick him and put him in the mid lane, one of the reasons he ended up making this comeback into the meta. And if you're not able to control those because you have an IO who's not the best in those situations, he's maneuverable, yes, but he's not really threatening, and a Witch Doctor as well versus Earth Spirit Lina, that's some scary stuff. And typically, it actually goes well against the Invoker, not only because he can do the acid, but because he doesn't go for the runes, so you get a, you know, innate advantage there. But I'm not feeling it here.
Well, Team Alternate. Waiting on one of their players. No, BZZ. We've seen few Alchemists recently. I think the last time I saw an Alc played was the C qualifiers for ESL1 Manila, I want to say. It was the Vietnamese team. It was Next Generation that played an Alc, and he completely just like ruffle stomped the opponents, like 20k net worth by 20 minutes kind of thing. But this was a hot pick at one time. Frankfurt Major, just before it, everyone was picking up Alchemist, getting, you know, the 13-minute Radiances and pushing into that really annoying Manta Octarine build, and people switched to, like, the Armlet build, and there was a bit of this, a bit of that. He's going to start off with a poor man's shield here, not going for the full bottle rush. He still wants to get his hands on that initial rune to get himself a nice chunk of gold. As F5, they're going to move themselves up as 4 towards his offlane, it looks like. Well, Team Alternate, Nisha. Boots first with an Observer Ward, going to Firefly over the cliffs and far away to try and get this ward down as quickly as possible. Looks like the placement's going to be on top of this single unit ramp, just to give vision across that area. The laning stage, is this going to be a Wisp Bristle dual offlane? Looks like that's the way they're kind of panning this one out, and against a Sven Lina, I could really bully them quite heavily.
Hmm. I almost wish it was like Fantastic Five that had the bat right here in this scenario. Because currently the way it's going to be set up, it looks like Nisha's going to have a giant advantage being sent down. How happy is he going to be to see Ghostick? Like, oh, sweet. This is the dream. So judging by his item build, it looks like he kind of knew this was happening because he fully bought out, has no stick. So I think they are predicting this.
Looks like it. Going to go for the bot rune contest to Team Alternate. This is going to secure it for BZZ up at top, though. This is kind of clever from Fantastic Five. The Team Alternate are still in a position where they can switch things up and move things around.
The battle begins.
Even though this Alc does get himself the Grievous Greed and the Bounty Rune up to 300 gold, easy as that. Wisp and Bristleback, they've got to make their decision and choose wisely where they head to, and it looks like they will swap it back again. F5 realize the potential here. But they've just been rustled. And they'll swap their lanes once more. It's musical chairs or musical lanes at this point, as both teams really vying for that advantageous matchup for themselves.
Does seem more important for Fantastic Five, though, doesn't it? Just because you are running the IO Bristle. Like, you want this powerhouse going as early as possible. And try and put on that nice early impact. Yeah, that's a roll into Yol, but get some good harass out from them. This isn't going to be as nice as most teams that do go for the IO Bristle these days. They actually lead out with the OD because they want that combo too moving into the mid game, but that won't be here for them.
Well, the Sash ticking, an absolute beating there from the Wisp and Witch Doctor. But Yol, he has left himself now on top of this ramp and he might be caught. The Lina's coming in. Yol turns to fight against the Earth Spirit. But Lina and Sven may be aiming towards RMN. They don't have enough damage to burst him down, and Yol's found a little path over further to the west, drawing these heroes off lane.
And away man, where from are the they creeps. Going? They're wandering, man.
They are hungry for kills, but they're not going to get any just yet. So, how are things going towards mid? BZZ Alchemist, he's getting his last hits in. 2 in the Acid Spray and forcing Supreme. Well, he hasn't forced him, actually, to go into the double quest, which I kind of expected. He wanted the extra bit of damage out from Sunstrike and the Forge Spirits. But Lina and Earth Spirit, they're swapping lanes now. Sven TP's top and they've put this Batrod down the bottom lane. I think Nisha needs to go and buy the stick now to get His quill spray stacking up the charges as quickly as he possibly can. Lesash is dealing with BZZ towards the mid, forcing him back up on top of the ramp away from the creep wave. But acid spray does its work. Magical stuff. And Yol's going to stack up for the arc as well. The question is, how does ATN pressure and push into this radiant jungle?
He bought a TP. He's going.
Money to burn. Who's going where?
This is Avos. He's going top, man. He's not done with him. Get back here, Sven.
Well, where's the Wisp? RMN's making a long wander over. He's hasting across the tower. He'll take a chunk of damage, but it's the fight over towards the Ancients where El Lesash, he has been spotted. And RMN with Yol chasing down the Earth Spirit, looking for this damage output. With a roll available, El Lesash should be able to get himself a little bit further away from this. And yeah, he gets towards the Ancients. He'll try and deny himself to this. Looks like he will not succeed. Alright, man. Snipes in with a nice little kill there.
Oh, just comes in with the bottle, helps out his mid. What a nice IO. I love this from Havos, though. Just so aggressive. We've seen in the past, teams are actually pretty reluctant to lane swap, especially multiple times, especially when you feel like you're the one who has, like, maybe the advantageous one, it seems, you know? Like, you're just like, oh, I don't want to try and, like, go again, and oh, free kill down bottom, it seems. Nice little roll in play.
But now they've got the aggressive trying up at top.
Yeah, I'm loving this. Good pull, too.
Invoker.
And they can still guard this. Like, I don't think Sven can come in.
Oh, no, he can't go near the creep wave. Between Witch Doctor and Bristleback, the Wisp keeping them sustained as well. Mid lane is where the pressure's being applied onto BZZ, but Forge Spirits die so quickly under this acid spray that Supreme's definitely having some difficulties, so they need the Earth Spirit to roll in onto BZZ. And now look for the boulder smash with the Sunstrike, but they're still holding onto it. They don't think they've got enough damage. Maybe could have gone for that, but it's always risky. With TPs coming in from Yol and helping them out. Oh, up at top, RMN swiped down. Exotic Deer has found a kill, but Havos, he wants to kill off the Lina. Dodges out of the Lightstrike array. Now he's getting these cool sprays stacked up. Oh, Lina fairy fires through. And this might be just fine for her. She'll get behind the tier 1 on 70 health. And secures herself the safety, but El Lesash hunting for Yol once more.
Did Havos just back? What just happened? Is that the right player? Someone tagged up as Havos.
It's obviously fake Nicker.
Yeah, I thought he was gonna go for that one, I gotta say, but better thoughts coming out there.
I just realized how awkward that word is to say. Like when you type that word, it's very obvious what you're saying, but when you say it out loud, yes, might not be saying that again. Someone has appropriated Havos' name. Well, moving on quickly. Nisha, Didierin bottled up with Earth Spirit sitting behind him. He's looking to maybe put a bit more pressure back onto Ghostick, who's just sitting back and allowing these boars to go to work. Has Sven been able to get a few last hits in? 20-1, not looking too shabby. Right, once Havos gets into that level 6 mark, or even, I guess level 7 when you've got a point in Goo as well, you really start to stick it to him.
I'm just waiting when Alchemist gives him the Aghanim Scepter. That's the joke, right?
Oh, with AoE goo. That's insane, you know, that spell.
Oh, I've never actually got to witness it.
Havos, that's a bit of a dive. Doesn't get anything from it. Takes 3 tower hits for free. Roll in onto bottom, though. They're looking for Ghostick. Bolt Smash is there, and the Sunstrike on the money once more. But Nisha just needs to stick on this target with RMN coming in to try and heal up this Beastmaster. It looks like he's still going to drop, though, with a tower dive coming through. Oh, Nisha. Not tanking up the tower as Elsa Sash keeps the damage onto him, and it's a double kill for Bat. RMN gives them a 2-for-1 special. Well, up at top, they've got the stun onto Havos. Lifestrike ready to follow. The cask is out, but there's the boulder smash again. Elsa Sash is going from lane to lane, but the damage output's not good enough. ATN, they've got to back up before Havos just pounds into them with these quill sprays stacking up so massively.
Oh, so touchy up here.
Dear
close
Lord.
For both sides. It looks like it's going to be the medallion blink build from BZZ because he has finished the treads, so he's not waiting up into bots or anything like that or expecting any sort of a relic. I think this is the one that we'd be expecting for the most part these days. Get aggressive, get your blinks. Potentially the armlet could come out, but we'll see.
Well, the thing is, Alchemist has been relatively untouched towards mid. You know, usually he sees himself against the Queen of Pain, or he would used to see himself against like a Shadow Fiend or someone like that, shoving these waves in and harassing him massively. But Supreme just hasn't been able to do that kind of job, and rotations have been few and far between. Between Earth Spirit and Lina, they've been dealing very heavily with Havos up on this top lane, so they've definitely drawn the aggro away from that middle lane. Oh,
Yeah, it almost makes you wonder, like, why he's not going into something a little bit more greedy, but I guess they just want to keep the pressure up and work more with the IO Bristle rather than use the IO Bristle to, like, buy time or something. He's even finishing up a magic wand, so... is under attack. BZZ wants to get active. Play some BZZ Dota.
They've also stacked up for the Batrider as well, though, so not only is Bat getting a good lane on bottom lane, he's also got some stacks to farm through and this Radiant Jungle, while BZZ ultimate ends. He's on the hunt for someone, but I just don't think he's going to be able to find anyone, even with that Radiant Observer Ward watching for the Lina. A little bit of a shimmy there, back and forth, back and forth. Lina tries to pull across, but here comes the concoction. They just need to keep the vision on them with a cast there. Lina definitely caught out. I'm not expecting the Alchemist just to come in and swipe him down. RMN is very low, but with the tether across, full bottle, he should be fine. Dyer's top to keep himself and the rest of his team alive. While Supreme, that's some good timing there on his hand of Midas.
Yeah, and so once again, we're going to be seeing him have a pretty good game on the Invoker. I mean, 7-minute Midas, it's hard to go wrong from here. Should be able to get up into that Yule Scepter fairly easily.
And spend just AFK's jungle.
Yeah. Yeah, precisely. There's the God Strength going out. Make sure you get the Massive Firm. He has only one stack.
He's at 1 point in cleave as well, dude.
What? Oh, I hate this.
I kind of feel he had to do this. Like, I only just noticed, but it feels like he had to. The double war cry against the Quill Sprays, going for the Stormhammer for like the aggressive turn plays onto the Wisp and the Witch Doctor, who are very squishy. But not having the cleave at this point, it just feels so wrong. Oh, Batrider finished off Boots of Travel, but instantly gets killed off there. Ghostick's first roar of the game. Yol and RMN both coming through as well to secure that kill up.
That's scary. That's like the last build you want when you die. Because now typically it's like, oh, I'm so greedy, like I can get Boots of Travel and then use that to farm faster up into my blink.
I think it's more of a, I'm about to die, I've got 2,000 gold. I'm,
is that what it was?
That can't be right. No, he's got like 600 gold saved up as well. Must have been a conscious decision.
Yeah.
Because I've definitely seen that and talked to players about that before. I think Bambo was one Bambo was one of the clear people that I've seen do it multiple times, where he buys like a Midas or a Boots of Travel. When he's like, right, I'm about to die, I've got 2 grand, I don't want to lose 400 gold or whatever it is and, you know, waste another 2 or 3 minutes farming. I just want to get an item here and now and spend up my gold. So Nisha with the BOTs, he will be able to move himself around a little bit freer and maybe utilize the jungles a little more. He won't have that blink initiation for himself, but I guess when you tie this in with Sven needing farm and...
Exactly, that's what it is. Because, like, who's going to want to help him right now with a Blink Dagger? Not Invoker, he's farming. Not Sven, he's farming. Like, it would just be the Lina. She's not even level 6, so... It's kind of like Pux, who would get that early Midas, right? Because the timing was just too soon for a Blink to be even that great. If they were, like, really snowballing. So, I can appreciate this.
BZZ
doesn't
mean that
they can't punish BZZ, though.
Especially when he's got his ultimate up. I mean, your damage output just... is it good enough? They've got a lot of it. A lot of stuns as well. They kill him. Even through that ultimate, I thought he'd be able to walk away scot-free with, you know, 8 stick charges and chemical range pumping through his blood. Steroids.
Yeah, I guess I should clarify, not without 4 heroes.
Well, steroids pumping through his veins were enough. From the little dude on his back. Regardless, Sven has been given some free time. Now with the Helm of the Dominator, he can start stacking up Ancients. I'm just waiting for the moment where they go and sentry this up, or, you know, place something over the top of it to stop the stacks from happening. Team Alternate, they're very good at utilizing their time and just efficiently farming across the map, getting into these key items, while F5, it always feels like they're on the brink of going over or under. They always feel like they're about to start a fight that they can completely crush or start a fight where they're going to get completely wiped. And Havosh definitely going to be one of the proponents in that. Looking for this tier 1 towards middle lane now with BZZ. As they do group up, they've got sustain about them, they've got some good lockdown with the Beastmaster's Roar. I just feel that nuke damage and actual killing potential can be a little bit lacking here if Team Alternate can kite just for a little bit in team fights.
There's a smoke coming in as well, looking to get aggressive here. Supreme has to be really careful.
Especially with that cask into concoction, they've got relocate in. And now this Invoker, he's not got a point in Wex, he'll just throw the Sunstrike. But 5 heroes from F5, all towards the middle lane, and that's it. They've got Voodoo Restoration level 2, none in Maledict, and they're coming for you. T1 Tier 2, not long for this world as the Glyph has even popped here, but defending it is going to be difficult. Sven up on top, the TP is coming through from Havo, so he'll TP himself back as Exotic D. Whoa, hello. Cancelled.
It's actually 3 points axes on the Beastmaster too.
Exotic Deer is going in for RMN. He needs another couple of punches through, and that cancelled TP will cost him his life. I don't know if that was a misclick or what happened there.
I can't think of any other reason.
Sure, I don't know. I surely you'd have the option where you don't cancel TPs unless you issue a hold command or something like that, but maybe he just doesn't have that.
Yeah.
It's a super useful option, by the way.
I've actually never turned it on, but I guess I probably canceled a TP or two in my day. One thing that's nice about Beastmaster that's not often talked about, like, his boar is sick up against Sven, too, but one thing that they've been doing, like, he's not currently doing it from Gosek, but he's been regularly having the boar right here, or the hawk, so they know there's no stacks already, plus, if your hawk's actually there, you can just move it in and block the stack every time. And it requires a sentry and an observer on that high ground to actually deal with it from ATN.
Batrider nearly has his Blink Dagger on top of this Boots of Travel. Nisha has done pretty well actually progressing himself through, but Team Alternate, they cannot defend their towers at this point. They just kind of have to let them go.
And the Blink's almost up for BZZ too, though. That's when we get to see the big jump. Full Concoction almost done too.
A tier 1 for a tier 2. And that's an Invoker buying a smoke. Don't see that too often, but he'll bring himself drums fully completed, and you're right, the Blink for Alchemist didn't get delivered as he did push the courier over to the side shop, but it's also coinciding with the Batrider Blink, who's got an Invis rune on top of it. End of the tier 3s though, that's where Alternate have to find themselves, trying to shove out these waves of Dragon Slaves. Crimson Guard is done for Havost, and Team Alternate, you've got to get yourselves back to this base and defend your high ground. It's 14 minutes in, and you're losing a tier 3 already. Some scary stuff from Fantastic Five, just the brute force being able to push up so early.
What if I Ghostig opted for 3 in the axes?
Instead of in a beast?
Yeah, considering the way they've been playing this game. Just seems it's like so much more the standard. It used to be this way on Beastmaster, but...
Well, you'd used to farm ancients and farm creep camps and stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
Or you just look for like the roar into axes and you just go for the damage. But Inner Beast has become such a vital skill there from his set. Fantastic Five. Maybe they feel they've got enough attack speed already between Bristleback and Alchemist, Chemical Rage, as well as Warpath, pump them up a fair amount. Maybe they just feel like they don't need it. And in the meantime, well, F5 are all grouped up around this tier 2. Roshan is taken by Team Alternate, and Sven is the one that picks it up. Interesting, it's not the Invoker.
Yeah, I gotta say, I'm a little surprised the way the Ghostic's actually been positioning the bird in the past, like, minute or about 3 minutes, actually, just the way they were pushing up top and keeping an eye up on this high ground where you're currently seeing Nisha sit, but you gotta think, I don't know if he just wanted to stay invis, but why not rotate it down maybe towards the Ancient, see if that's where the Sven in fact is, or even in towards the Roshan pit, which obviously that is what was going on. It is very early, but up against the Exor and Invoker, obviously you've got to be ready for that pretty much any moment past, like, what, like 9 minutes essentially if he disappears off the map? Oh, nice. Red River start.
Might take a while. 2016. Roshan's only take like a minute to restart. Come on, lads, get it together. So what's next for BZZ? Medallion, Blink, then what? Assault Cuirass? Do you finish the Solar Crest? What do you look for as this Alchemist?
I like the Solar Crest.
Evasion against the Sven, pretty good against Force Spirits and Invoker. Yeah. Keep yourself alive through it all, become invincible. Even maybe throw it onto Havost, who has himself an Ogre Club. Could be SNY, but equally BKB is going to be pretty important for him here against Earth Spirit in particular. Even that Lina with the Laguna Blade pumps out a hell of a lot of damage. Well, RMN is going for the Bracer Gaming on this Wisp. It's all very geared towards early game here, though, for F5. You know, they haven't allowed themselves too much leeway to progress into late game. This has to go well. If they lose a couple of fights in the next 4 or 5 minutes or something like that, Team Alternate could potentially run away with this.
Yeah, there's no question on that. Pretty much the only person who hasn't, like, itemized for this is essentially just Ghostic, but that's just because he's a Beastmaster. So... And him and Yoel are just like, it's okay, guys. We got the late game secured. It's fine. I mean, what is this? 14-minute Crimson Guard? That must be a little frustrating as a Sven. It's like, how do you like it? You know? This war cry you've been passing around, everybody. Got our own Crimson Guard now. He's got a really hard game ahead of him for Exotic Deer. This is very difficult. Not where you want to be as a Sven. Like, he's got that tough call of like, oh, like I can't even go for the SNY now. I have to probably go for either BKB or Blink. I think if I go for Blink, I'm going to die.
I think you just have to go Blink, and you have to rely on your Batrider and your Lina being there for you. So you get like the Blink Lasso onto the Wisp, and you just chunk him down with a stun and a few hits of the... Oh my god. God strength. Like my brain just went through all of his skills except the one that I wanted to say. The heat has got to me, Mopax. It's melted. It's melted through my
what's
brain.
What's going on? Is it like hot in the? Is it hot in Germany right now?
Yeah.
Oh.
Studio air conditioning is also broken.
Oh dearie me.
Plus all the lights and the PCs and all the studio equipment, and I'm a whiny little bastard as well. So you know that doesn't help.
Yeah, it's mostly that, I'd say.
Definitely mostly that. It's all about the whining. I'm English after all. We've got to have something to whine about, you know? Always whine with a smile. Easy. Pops his ultimate. That should be a simple tier 3. While the rest of Team Alternate, they're actually just sticking around bottom lane, dodging these fights. Oh, Alchemist. Lina.
Yeah, there was a quick charge blink. Not much that Lina could do. Came in for that little dragon slave, and that was it.
She should not have been that far forward. I mean, Batrider was dealing with top lane, two heroes were bot. Fantastic Fire, they're just securing this entire map. Bot lane, though, is where they have to start aiming for within the next couple of minutes. And the big thing is they don't get to take Roshan. That little snipe out from Team Alternate, it may not seem like much. It's like, oh, they made the best of a bad situation. But it just takes so much momentum away from F5 not having Aegis on this Bristleback or the Alchemist. They can't just walk up to high ground with impunity. And now, wait, that's a relocate alone. They didn't bring the Bristleback. I guess they cancelled it and realized they weren't going to get the kill. And Havoskin can continue just farming Ancients.
Alrighty. It's okay, he's got his Sahnj done. Iron Man just goes on a little expedition. Maybe they didn't watch Air EXP. Let's get out of here. My Ancients. So how can they capitalize off this Aegis anyway? Batrider, I guess, has to be the chief executive fight decider.
Oh, nice pairing. Batrider into the Sunstrike. Lasso comboed up, and Nisha gets closer towards that Force Staff Blink Dagger combination, but Ghoststick, I think he may have been considering the roar into Necro 2 there if Nisha had stuck around a little bit longer. Would have burnt through all of his mana and definitely looked towards that kill. Supreme has been given so much time here now, with Midas Drums heading into that Aghanim Scepter as quick as he can. Need to stop pumping points into this Wex as well, because Tornado becomes very important for you. Like I was saying before, still no BKBs over on F5. So Tornado EMP, or just EMP Ice Wall, something like that. That puts a stop to a push immediately.
Yeah, I gotta say, when you suggested during the draft even to swap over to the boss Wex, I really think that was the play to go, honestly. Mid lane probably would have went better, if anything. Up against the Alchemist, you haven't had much of a chance to actually execute anything from your Exor build, really. Just because of the setup and the way things went from Fantastic Five's end. And it's just much better in these D-push scenarios, but in the end, this is the way we've gone. And BZZ and crew, Solar Crest up, easily going to clear out these last two towers. They're trying to desperately grab whatever else they can off the map while they have an idea as to where they actually are. But it's scary. The relocate's still there. It's not an IO Tiny, though, so, like, Melina can be a lot more forward than I think you typically see her until there's, like, a Blink Dagger up on Havos or something, which I'm kind of surprised he's not opting for, honestly. I guess because they just want to push in. They're not concerned about chasing.
It's always with the buddy system as well. Sven Invoker, Batrider plus Lina, but they have to come back to defend their tier 3. BZZ, he went forward looking for something. The Sunstrike, Deafening Blast, not going to land perfectly, but the roar is onto Lina. And now they're looking for the go. Zelisash gets magnetized into a couple of RMN. Tethers back, the Death Ward is down. Supreme, he's dropping low, but the concoction will not allow them to find that final kill. Oh, RMN and Ghoststick, they've actually caught them together. They're being brought down, the Magnetize and the Dragon Slave. The Lina returns to the Land of the Living, and Exotic Deer is still hunting them down. He's still got Aegis Immortal for about a minute or so. Not going to be able to utilize it just yet, as the rest of F5 will bail themselves away, but y'all, barely escapes. No boulder smash or cold snap. But high ground has been defended here by Team Alternate and Fantastic Five. They expended a lot and lost a lot. Might even lose a BZZ as he's already used his blink. Firefly forward. The flame break. Going to go with the concoction under Nisha. A few punches here, but the LSA Laguna Blade from Lina will secure it. Even the Sunstrike thrown by Supreme. Team Alternate have definitely come out heavy victors in that battle, though. This is what I was kind of pointing at, is if F5 don't close out this game by, what, 25, 30 minutes? The builds that they've gone for, not particularly good at scaling.
Yeah, it's a really difficult window for them, because you can see they came high ground, Exotic Deer popped that war cry, and they just were not dying. The Death Ward was going, and nothing was happening. People were just, like, dancing around inside of it. And yeah, it's a low level, but the massive amount of armor that they have, this is definitely the lineup to be up against, right? Like the Alchemist, Bristleback, coming in, punching your face, so. It just looks like it's some easy peasy high ground. The Aghanim Scepter is essentially done here for Supreme, and they're gonna need a bigger pick this time from Fantastic Five if they want to try that again, or at least the Aegis.
It's just been really well executed by ATN, going from side to side, taking tier ones. That's mid tower, obviously. On low HP is going to be something they aim towards in the next couple of minutes. But the Aghanim Scepter on Invoker is huge. Max Exhort now, plus one. They've got to get the points in Wex up and running now for this Supreme Invoker, though. Like I was saying before, EMP, incredibly important. While F5, they know which buttons they have to press. It's just a matter of finding a time to actually press them. They're going to go for tier three up at top lane. 400 health. With no glyph available, Supreme should Ice Wall get himself this barrier to stop the push coming in. And with the Four Spirits here, it's so difficult to actually breach for F5. They need to find the jump. They need that initiation tool. But it's BZZ that holds it. Following through onto an Alchemist, blinking in a million range and actually having damage to actually go on top of this is almost impossible. They have no Queen of Pain. They have no Sunstrike. They've got no big damage to actually land onto the concoction.
Like, they don't have Nisha. I mean, he's just got this Force Staff ready to punish so heavily. BZZ has to go. Uh-oh.
That's a self-stun there with the last one to the Wisp. Sunstrike Meteor is down to BZZ. Laguna Blade pushes him off with a fall. Ice Wall is down, stopping Havos from running rampant, but it's the Roar. Exotic Deer is actually held in place with the Death Ward down. Havos turns to fight him, but this Bristleback, he cannot survive through the DPS of that Invoker. And Team Alternate, they're just going to clean up. One after the other, Yol should get swiped down by the Sven. And the big old sword he holds cleaves through the poor little doctor. And even RMN stands his ground, realizing what's coming. Will get killed off by a tornado. Triple kill for Supreme, and again, the high ground is defended. Fantastic Five. Not looking so flipping fantastic anymore, are they?
No. That roar did come out at a nice timing, though. I'm sure it would have been like five men right away if the roar hadn't come out, but in the end, they clean up four anyway, so. Not too much of a difference made, and talk about the fact they have to make something happen. They have to go in, and BZZ, he went for it. He YOLO'd, and it did not pay off. Man, that self-stun, that was disgustingly brutal. I don't know if the play was like, if it misses, we're going to relocate you back out and then reset or something, but it did not come out. It was a nice lasso by Nisha, just making sure to focus the IO. And that was pretty much the end of the fight once that happened. From there, it was just Fantastic Five trying to disengage.
That's a straight up BKB for Exotic Deer as well. Sven, he's found himself a good amount of farm, and you don't see this often, right? Alchemist, fourth in net worth from a core position. Not even breaching 10k as BZZ. There's no Radiance build, of course. He has gone for the aggressive fighting build, but you need to keep these items coming in. He's not a late game scaling carry. He doesn't have scaling abilities. He's similar to Anti-Mage in that respect, you know, you get your initial items and you farm bloody quickly to get your items faster than any of your opponents. But if at any point you get behind, it becomes so difficult to flip the script and actually get yourself ahead again.
Yeah, he's one of those, I would say, fewer heroes that's balanced totally around money, really. Just him and Anti-Mage, and the whole plan being trying to get it up as fast as possible. And yeah, you get this Solo Crest, this Blink, it's amazingly early. But then you fall into this pit, and then you have to try and like get together. You have two choices. You can try and go for like one more item like this. Some people I've seen, like Vlad's, maybe, you know, just get another aura item. We're gonna stack up, we're gonna go high ground, or maybe you'll go for a quick armlet, like something that can still try and work with the tempo you were at a little bit later, and make it happen, or you go full, like, all right, sort of the game plan, we're going over, I'm getting like a Radiance, or I'm getting a Battle Fury, or I'm getting a Maelstrom, whatever you can afford at the time, start going back into this like farming route, but you've got an IO Bristleback. And yeah, that's where they're kind of locked in here.
I kind of feel it has to be something like the Maelstrom just to give him some more damage output. Maelstrom Mjolnir than an AC, but they need BKBs more than anything. You're looking at this. I'm looking at this, and you know, 6 or 7 minutes ago I said they lack the damage, but now they're lacking the survivability. They're lacking the actual head-on-head aggression, because they were this unstoppable force. But ATN were an immovable object standing up on the high ground. That this force has just been diminished so heavily that they need to go back for defensive items and aggressive items on the same heroes. And the Blink Dagger on Ghost Stick, that gives them some more aggression and mobility across this teamfight landscape. But between Alchemist and Bristleback, they're tanky, but they're not tanky enough. They're not invincible.
Yeah, they did really need that Blink, though. They had zero initiation. They're actually just going to smoke right away, too.
Radiant's middle tower has been denied.
I'm not sure. I guess, I don't know where that smoke came from.
Who, the Beastmaster? Beastmaster was bot lane and solo smoked, I think. Or was it with the Witch Doctor? Because he doesn't have inventory slots for the smoke. Huh.
Yeah, I don't know what happened.
He was definitely bottom lane, like, 30 seconds ago.
I think they accidentally popped it. I think the Witch Doctor did. It's the only explanation I have.
Oh, the snipe on the hawk with the Sunstrike Supreme. What a godlike player. Invoker?
Getting them with the tornadoes last game, too. Like, always going right across the cliffs.
Well, Roshan is alive, but it's a smoke into smoke, and Yol scouted by Nisha. The stun, the roar is there onto the Batrider, but in comes the Sven, stuns up the Alchemist, and with his God Strength, he's just slamming him into the ground. BZZ cannot stun anyone, but he denies himself! Suicide committed by the Alt, but it's a fight that F5 have to win. They need to win, but I don't know if they can win. The mana pools are diminished here, but Lina still lands a Light Striker Ray onto Ghost Stick, another stun from Exotic Deer will get himself a double kill, and they're running forward onto Havost, but the Bristleback will just turn and fight. They cannot kill him, and Exotic Deer is forced to TP away. Still a 4-2. And with Bristle the only one left standing, Team Alternate definitely the ones on the front foot again. 9-16, 24 minutes in against an early game lineup of Supreme. What's he up to? 1v1ing a Bristleback. Ghostwalk is there. Sticky situation, but Havost, he's not going to be able to kill him off. Supreme gets himself away, reading the situation perfectly, it seems.
All right, well, sick deny. Got to give him props for that one.
Who, the Alt?
Yeah.
Lucky. Oh, come on, lucky deny.
Don't be like that. Come on. Did you see the relocate in from Iron Man as well? That was actually sick. He picked off the Batrider fleeing away from that Necro 3. He got him, like, right over here. Oh, that was pretty well played. Kind of saving at least part of that engagement. And then with the deny from Alchemist, I thought maybe they'd be able to trade evenly, but... It was a good catch it as well onto Ghost Stick there. Just to make sure it was a full-out fight win there from the side of ATN. Roshan now back up. Both teams, I'm sure, will be aware once the Sunstrike comes out, if it hasn't already.
This is the second time he's Sunstruck into the pit. So they know it's up, and now they probably know that Havost is over towards the pit and actually trying to take this one out. Team Alternate. Roshan's dying very quickly. Negative 11 on the armor value there. But Elder Sash. He's already stolen Aegis once this series. Let's see if he can do it again. He's not going to roll in fast enough. And Roshan, Aegis picked up by the Alt. There's the drag back, y'all. Oh, the stun. Two man. Exotic Deer cleaving through a couple of them. Ghost Stick cannot even roar. And Exotic Deer with his BKB up looking for BZZ with the Sunstrike down onto him. Havost is shredded by the Lina's Laguna Blade. And this might just be game over. Fantastic five. Are they going to lose five? Wisp is even found in the back.
BKB is a good item. Solid item. Exotic Deer, man, he was just ripping and tearing, and the roar did not get to come out that fight. And if that's not there, there's just nothing to slow him down. God, Sven, what a hero. And for me, wasn't he like way behind earlier? Yeah, he was like way behind. Went in for this like two stun build, then he had to go and hide himself away in the jungle, farming away desperately in the Radiant side. Do you remember this? They were like down here farming, and then up top farming with like a Lina. They were losing all their towers, and they were just like hiding and hiding. And now who is like king of the castle, man? Exotic Deer. Supreme 3.5k gold.
Supreme even has himself a full Lincoln's completed, so Roar and Concoction and all that nonsense not going to really do too much harm to him. There's the Maelstrom from Alchemist, but it's a last-ditch effort, really. It's a desperation item if there ever was one. As Havosh still not moved on from his SNY Crimson Guard. Just seeing new item after new item from Team Alternate here. Already one game up in his best of three. Looking to close this one out as a 2-0. RMN's Wisp. Treads, Urn, Drums. Try and keep Havosh alive through these team fights. But again, I just feel like it's Eldest Ash. It's not just his early laning stage dominance, but his team fight positioning has been spectacular. Like, a lot of people don't think about this, and I know it's been said a fair amount recently, but Magnetize, getting these like two or three man stuns and geomagnetic grips and silences and slows and everything, he is just demolishing. You know, Ghoststick not being able to get the Roar in the last fight is because of the Earth Spirit. Wisp not being able to keep the Bristle of the Arc alive because of the Earth Spirit. Sure enough, you see the flashy two man stuns and the cleave from the Sven, but it's the Earth Spirit that is actually doing the heavy lifting in these team fights.
Yeah, it's true. I mean, Sven's nothing without the controlling allies that he has, right? So, and that is something that they've now given away twice. And you've got to be wondering, like, I feel like Earth Spirit is not that hero that you just respect ban for certain players anymore. It's like, if they have any semblance of able to play this hero or willing to play this hero, I feel like you ban it over Bounty Hunter.
And Supreme's Invoker as well.
Yeah, that's also kind of questionable.
Ghoststick.
Oh, nighttime is... That's
and then Team Alternate just throw a couple of spells out, making sure that there's no jump in from F5. Batrider. Aggressive blink, but sentries and obs with a smoke now from the back end of plate. F5 still want to fight into this, and I wonder. They do. They know Supreme is here. He catches one with a tornado, though, with a deafening blast meteor. There goes the Roar. The Lincoln was popped earlier with a death ward down. Supreme is forced out of the way. He's kept alive, and there's no damage output. F5. They have no position in this team fight to be able to do anything. They'll barely even scratch onto the Invoker, and they will not kill a single hero while Havosh, he is chased down into oblivion with a push back into the freaking Sunstrike. It's just crisp, clean execution. And their heads are rolling. Four dead again. BZZ, time to TP. Clear out the creep wave and cut across it, but Team Alternate attacks. 3.2k exchange once more. And let's take a look.
Four dead.
You degenerate, honestly.
I know.
Forehead. Ellie giggle.
Alright, Ghoststick coming back. The last Bastion defense. 20 seconds to Roar. Everyone's up and active here. I don't know. Well, except for apparently. I'm not sure what Nisha's doing. He's like, nah. I'm cool, guys. I don't really feel like doing anything.
Lina with the Yule Scepter, Aether Lens, and Arcane Boots looking pretty happy with the items she's got. What did Sven spend his money on? Oh. Just the casual Moonshard, you know.
Excellent. I was actually hoping that's what he'd go for. I think that's worth, with how competent his team has shown to be with controlling, with the levels, the Aghanim Scepter and Supreme, Earth Spirit, as well as a Batrider, I think that makes total sense. Like, what's his concern? What worry does he have? He knows that his God Strength is going to be enough, and he doesn't need damage items right now. He knows that, like, they're so good right now, and they're so far ahead that I'm just going to pop R, I'm going to blink in, I'm going to use my BKB, and that's going to be it. That's going to be my total fight contribution. I'm not worried about fighting without my God Strength because we're not going to screw it up.
F5, they're trying to ward up towards their ancients and put themselves in a high ground position where they can maybe hold out in a team fight. This is so difficult, though.
How about we just get aggressive with the smoke? I assume that's what they're doing, at least.
I don't know. I'd be scared running into ATN at this point.
Oh, no, sorry, I meant ATN.
Oh, right.
They're grouping up.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah. And, this is definitely the defensive. Help me. Hold me.
Just stay on high ground, guys. Don't get caught. Don't get solo picked off. Even looking at buybacks, what do we have? Alk, Beastmaster, Wisp all have theirs available. BKB is finally up for Havost, so they've got that 9 second... Oh, he had it in the last team fight. It's down to 9 seconds now. An Alchemist, nowhere near his own one. While a Batrider with Lincoln Sphere can trade it out for the bottle. He even has that Veil of Discord to add in for all the magic damage from Earth Spirit as well as the Lina. Sven. At this point, Team Alternate, they could potentially just wait for the next Roshan. Find a pick off here or there, stop F5 from farming efficiently, keep all these lanes pushed out.
Yeah, gotta imagine that's the plan here for them. Oh, there we go. There's the grab. Oh, the Mosty.
Oh, he's dead. He is straight up dead. Oh, maybe he's not. RMN keeps him alive, and they didn't even force the BKB from Havost.
What a player.
I might have lied a little bit there. Even with the Laguna Blade, it wasn't enough damage to kill him off.
Now, did they go back in? Oh, they did actually. Sorry, they didn't hang around this time, knowing they just wasted everything. ATM playing this very smartly. Smartly. That's not a word.
Intelligently. Well, cleverly.
Wisely.
Hello.
Real smart-like.
Real smart. Oh, God. RMN casually just sidesteps to Sunstrike, hides in the trees. Supreme uncharacteristically misses one of them. But Nisha just keeps the pressure on, looking at him farming enemy jungle, limiting the presence that F5 can have on the map. And then TPing up the top to do exactly the same thing over there as well. Hemmed back in their base, the bunker they call their own. Fantastic five. I would say they've got a lot of work to do. But I honestly don't know. They're on food stamps here. Getting into the queue for the dole. Signing on.
Yeah.
Trying to get money.
Hope they screw up mode.
Yeah. Just try and save up enough money from the government until Team Ultimate just like wander in and throw away a couple of kills. Team Ultimate for now aren't really going to be playing too aggressively, but Roshan is up and Elzash will scout this one out. RMN just drawing big old circles on the map saying, guys, we need to do stuff in this general area, you know? This big box here where Dota 2 happens, we need to go and do things. I think Roshan should just be sniped out here by Alternate. Nothing really that Fantastic Five can do about this. Aegis and Cheese. It's going to be a relatively simple little berry picking operation. With that Basher for Havost, he actually forgoes his buyback and buys out for it.
I guess that makes sense just because ATN, like, they don't have to commit to fights. If Havost dies, they can probably just run. I don't feel like there's much catch or anything that's going to, like, force them to engage, so they'll just, like, leave. He buys back, and then it'll be a total waste. So rather than that, he's going to go for the Basher and try and add a little bit of lockdown. And try and get one of these big key targets, so hopefully they can just continuously kill and maybe delay this eventual game-winning push from ATN. And it looks like that push is coming now, Nisha. It is going to be almost nighttime. That's when it's going to be mostly favoring ATN, I'd say, just because of the Batrider in terms of, like, him being able to snipe out from the sides. They can get a nice aggressive ward in. There are no sentries down. Do they have any wards with them? They don't. So Nisha has to play hard mode. They'll smoke up instead.
I'm pretty sure that was spotted though. The pings are coming out from F5 and they definitely know, but Havost, oh dearie me, with a Sunstrike, paired up with a Wisp there, he does not get picked off. Now to heal him up and relocate him back into the thick of things, but with no Glyph available, oh, there's the Glyph, never mind. I'll do that so often. The Glyph popped at exactly the same time as I'm looking for it. Oh, the two-man stun, the God Strength, yo, oh, RMN now with BZZ dragged back into the meat grinder, Exotic Deer just slams him down. Two buybacks are available from F5, but I think this might just be over, Mottpax. Havost held inside the ice wall, pops his BKB, now he's free to run around. A little change to ice wall, not actually penetrating after the BKB's pop, but RMN caught by Exotic Deer. A couple of hits are all he needs, but Supreme is hiding in that ghost wall, pops the tornado forward, and Exotic Deer beyond godlike after such a devastating laning phase. Fantastic Five ripped apart at the seams.
It must be nice playing Sven with a team like this, hey?
Or just being able to do whatever the hell you want.
Yeah, he bought Moonshard and he makes it look like the best build ever, which is something that we've seen so many people fail with before, but the control from his allies, the full 25 seconds of God Strength was disgusting right there. I mean, he took the racks, he killed some heroes, he was cleaving numerous units at a time, like it was nothing.
And now it's back up again in 25 seconds.
Yeah, you know, he's just missing his Octarine core. I need nothing but God Strength. My team will carry me.
Well, Team Alternate, second laner Axe. Now looking for the third, the safe. Easier way to finish this game, but Havos is dragged back into the Sven with the lasso. The Firefly, deafening blast. Havos is dead, but he has Flyback this time around. Sunstrike will be just on the mark, actually. Barely scraping onto the Witch Doctor. Look at that, God Strength. He's on the deer. He doesn't care about buildings. Just pummel straight into them. Oh, the roar is captured out. Tornado and Ice Wall hold him in place. There's Sven. He's being dropped a little bit here by Havos, but the damage output is going to be good enough to finish off the racks, it looks like, with ATN clearing up through numerous heroes. Good game is just straight up cool. Fantastic 5, tap out. 10 to 34, game number 2. It was a lot more one-sided.
Yeah, man, ATN looking very strong. Team people definitely consider being underdogs coming into this one with all the big names on Fantastic 5, but they are still relatively new, working together, so this is one of those advantages that we do sometimes see from, like, Tier 2 teams that have been together longer. They end up coming with some bigger wins and maybe times you don't expect it. I appreciate the fact that Nisha's going to stamp one into Dat Dodo with the E-Blade purchase on his Batrider. Well played. As well as his Veil. He's got all the right items here.
Wait, has E-Blade Bat never been done?
Oh, I don't know. I'm sure it's been done at least once or twice.
Okay.
But he gets to be part of it now.
Sure. Of course he does. Well, that's it for tonight. That is it for tonight. No more best of threes. We're all done. 2-0. Team Alternate take the victory here in this series. Tomorrow, though, we will be back with more ESL 1 Frankfurt EU qualifiers. Two more best of threes starting at 5 p.m. CEST. And if I could just quickly bring up exactly which games we've got for you tomorrow, which is it's going to be VP against ATN, as well as Spirit against Nodigity, it looks like. Starting with the VP against ATN game. So, we should have some crackers for you tomorrow. So, make sure you check that out. But also, what you should check out is Motpax, because he is a wonderful man. And he has a Twitter account. Which is...
I do. It's just add Motpax. It's really complicated.
So there's no numbers in it?
No. No numbers, no underscores, no lines.
Damn.
No pretty women. There's nothing. It's just me, guys. Sorry.
Pictures of cats embedded...
No.
What's your pinned tweet?
Well, back when I had 300 games stat or cast, but man, I must be way past that now. I might have doubled.
You do not
it's
have
been
a pinned...
busy couple of months.
You do not have a pinned tweet, Motpax.
Oh, I must have removed it. Sorry, guys. Yeah.
Well, no regardless, pass. We'll be back tomorrow, or I'll be back tomorrow with some more best of threes. Not sure who's casting with me, but I'm definitely not going to be alone. See you guys then.